Yeah, but which is why I had to put him on blast. I mean, that was another thing. That was him fighting with his spirituality and feeling like because he had came to this place spiritually that he was embarrassed about it, you know, that he had said all of these things. It's just like his eyes were open to, like, I don't need to, you know. Larry Graham challenged him on the situation. Like, he asked him, he said, man, you know, could you do your songs without swearing? And, you know, and Prince told me the story. He said, well, yeah, you know, of course I could. He said, but it's like he got his hand spanked and he realized that, you know, I could say what I wanted to say without, you know, being provocative in that kind of a way. And, you know, and it's just growing up, man. It's just like, you know, for me, you know, it was a lot of racy stuff that was done. And sometimes it was a bit over the top to me. You know, I was like, ooh, okay. But it got to where everybody could come to his show, man. Like, kids could come. Nobody had to cover their ears. You know, it was a good time for everybody. And I really dug that, man. I like the fact that anybody from any age could come. And they wouldn't feel like, oh my God, I gotta, like, you know, like, tape my kids' ears and in their eyes so they don't see all the. I mean, it was cool. It just made it like everybody could come and enjoy it. And I dug that, man. I really don't have a problem with that. You know, Prince was young. He did a lot of stuff that youngsters do. He was rambunctious, man. He'd jump out on the ledge, and I mean, that's what you do when you're a kid. And, you know, youth is wasted on the young. I get it. But he grew up and he just came to a place where he matured and was more concerned about everybody's experience than just, you know, a lot of people who like to, yeah, say everything. You know, he was a clever guy. He could say anything he wanted to say and you still get the message, but he didn't have to be vulgar about it.